お互いに。
Yes, people, them. Welcome back to Mario Worldwide. I know I've been off for a while. A couple of things was going on in my life. I was trying to sell your auntie half a Z. But moving on from that, so we're going to get into another story time today. Now, obviously, like I said, my channel is going to be about, you know, different content. But I'm just going to hit you with the story times until I can get the production line fully going. You get me? So, yeah, this story time is about the first time I got high. Now, you're probably thinking, this guy probably buns bare. A lot of people say by looking at me, they think I'm a smoker. I don't smoke, yeah? Not even on a semi-regular basis. You know, sometimes when there's a celebration, I might partake in the herb. But normally, I'm not about that life. Because, you see, when I smoke, I get very paranoid, yeah? So, if I smoke and I go out in public, I'm going to be looking at grannies, think say that they're fed, and I might smack them up.
Police! Help! Police! Help! Police! Help! Help!
I might get very tapped, so that's why I stay away from the weed. You get me? So, this was the first time I got high. This was a good few years ago now. I'm not going to reveal my age, but this was a good few years ago. And this was during a trip. Now, during these times, I was involved, well, I still am involved in acting and performing arts, so we went to go to the theatre. I can't remember the play. I think it was some Rambo thing. I can't even remember what it was, but it was in Central. Obviously, it being in theatre, it was the West End. So, the group I was with, after the play ended around 8 o'clock, we're like, we're in Central, we might as well do a little thing, innit? So we went to Leicester Square, and these people I was with, they brought out a grinder. Now me, I was raised in a very closed household, so I thought it was a yo-yo effect.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
You get me? I thought the grinder was a yo-yo, bro. You know how it looked? It was green. You know them yo-yo that used to light up when you was a youth? So, I thought it was a yo-yo. But then, I started to smell a whiff of a little something. You know when the feds smell something, they say, I smell cannabis. That's what went off in my head. I smell cannabis. So, one of the people I was with, they passed me the grinder, and they're like, Romario, grind this thing. I was like, fuck it. I started grinding it. I'm still not thinking I'm going to partake in the weed. I finished grinding it. They start billing it now right in front of me. Yeah. And me personally, I'm like, is this about to happen right now, fam? Like, is this actually going to happen right now? Everyone else around me is calm. But I'm standing there thinking like, yo, fam, am I about to be corrupted, fam? Like, am I about to burn in hell? Like, what's
I come in the name of Jesus. Repeat it after me, bitch. I come in the name of Jesus by the power of the Holy Spirit. God Almighty, you know.
What's going on, innit? Because I've never smoked weed before this, innit? So, they get done billing it now. They light the thing. They take a draw. They pass it to me. This was the moment of truth, innit? This is maybe one of the very few times in my life I succumb to pure pressure, yeah. I'm thinking like, nah, man's not about that life. Man's not trying to partake in a high grade. Like, I'm just here for the vibes, innit? Man's here for the vibes. But all eyes were on me, fam. I felt like I was on a game show. All eyes were on me. It was called Smoke the Spliff, Smoke the Zeggy. That was the game show I was on. So they're all looking at me now. I'm looking at them like, yeah, fam. Like, I didn't know it, but fam, I said, fuck it, blood. You get me? So, took the spliff. Man took the take, fam.
It's the Bombay.
First, it was calm, innit? Like, I didn't really feel anything. I was just there innit. But then I think I took another one. Now this second talk was a moment of truth, car. I started to feel a bit different. I started to feel a bit weird, you get me? You know what I'm saying? And then, like, after this, we're in Leicester Square, yeah? And no, we started to leave Leicester Square, and then we saw, like, a security guard, innit? He was just some any normal bouncer, yeah? In my head, this is when I started to go a bit tapped. In my head, I thought it was a fed, innit? So, I started running! I was gone. Usain Bolt 99 acceleration, fam. R2, bruv. I was gone. I'm Mbappating, fam. Yeah? I was gone. People, they don't, fam. Everyone started laughing at me, innit? Because, like, Romario, this is not a fed. This is a security guard. Like, chill, innit? And then after that, I started to calm down a bit. But it was central, so things were still open. It was, like, around maybe Christmas time. So shops are open longer, innit? So we went into M&M mode, yeah? Now, this is when I started to clock, when I really started to clock, things was not right, fam. Because when we went into M&M mode, they have, like, these life-sized M&M statues, innit? The yellow and the red donny, yeah? When I tell you, I'm looking at these things like they're the size of fucking, I don't even know, the BFG Iron Giant thing. And I start to get a bit shook. I'm like, oh my god! Hey fam, these M&Ms are looking a bit mad, bruv. Like, I actually felt like the M&Ms were going to attack me, like some Optimus Prime thing. So after that, I said, fuck it, let's go in it. So we left. And then after that, we just walking around. And you know what's mad? Because I was in Central, there's bare lights. I felt like I was in Wonderland, fam. I felt like I was in The Wizard of Oz. I'm seeing all these lights, all these colours. I felt like, I don't know, fam. I felt like I was on shrooms. Like, I felt like I was gone. I felt like I was in Mario, bruv. Mario World, like. It was a mad experience. So we keep walking, and then we go to McDonald's, yeah? And then my friend sitting across from me, we order our food. All of that, you know, McDonald's, innit? We ordered the food, and then my friend sitting across from me, she was right there. She was as far as I'm from the camera, but it felt like she was like 10 miles away. And the further, like, the more I kept looking at her, the further I got. So all now, man's just going back in my seat, feeling like I'm zoning off, like I'm in some type of Twilight Zone, like, you know what I'm saying? But then, obviously, that wasn't the case. But anyway, this is a lesson for people, innit? Like, say no to drugs. Actually, fuck that. I'm not going to be one of them youth. If you want to smoke weed, be careful who you smoke it with and make sure in a controlled environment and make sure you can afford it. Because there's enough broke man that ain't got nothing to do in their life. They ain't got nothing to do. They're scratching their ball bags, picking their bum, but they can still afford weed. So if you can afford the weed, if you got a plug, you can do that, innit? But don't make sure the weed isn't like a loss of cash. So boom, that was another episode of Mario Worldwide. Make sure that you like, share and subscribe, hit the notification button. Also, as you lot know, I'm a member of the Faithful Black Men podcast. We're soon to be dropping some new content, some new exciting content. I'll link that in the description below as well. And yes, people, them, this is Mario Worldwide. Boom! Maniac Beats. Woo.